Welcome to episode 43 of Daily Flip. Today's been a little bit of a hectic day. We've had a lot going on. I started out doing paperwork. Didn't end up doing that much of it because I was all over the place everywhere today. So I'm gonna walk you around, show you what's been going on. It actually started out this morning with a phone call. Actually, last night I had someone call interested in a GMC Envoy. I'll take you outside and show you that Envoy right now. It's a 2004, it's actually this one right here. This was a trade-in on a 2006 Mercury Mountaineer that we had a couple weeks ago. So they called last night. They were actually asking if there was a bus stop close by. So they actually rode the bus in this morning. I thought they were coming from this way. There's a bus stop right over there. They were coming from inside downtown Raleigh, so I kind of directed them the wrong way. So when I was pulling in this morning at 9:30, got in a little bit late, had basketball this morning and had to take the kids to school and all that good stuff. But when I was pulling in this morning coming from this way, I saw some people walking across the street. One of them actually was on crutches, and it was the folks that were interested in buying the Envoy. So crossing this busy street on crutches probably wasn't the best idea. That's probably halfway my fault because I gave them the wrong directions. But long story short, they got in this morning. They took the car up to their credit union, which is about 5 minutes that way. They came back in about 30 minutes and they kind of had their heads hanging low. They didn't get approved. They asked if I had a lender or if I financed. I don't. I don't like to be the bank. I don't want to be knocking on someone's door repossessing a car. Just don't have time for that. But I said, I've got a lender. Let me see what we can do. I took the credit application. I sent it over to a bank up the road, actually Lendmark Financial. Most anyone has access to that. But as a dealer, I can send applications and have them processed. They got the application. In about 20 minutes, they called me back and said, hey, numbers are good. Send the customer down. Our only problem occurred when they were trying to get their pay stubs. Their company couldn't fax them over. They couldn't fax the right ones. And their insurance is like almost done. So we're waiting on the insurance and we're waiting on the pay stubs. They had to leave because they had to be at work at 2:30. So they were here from 9:30 to 2:30 trying to get this figured out. It was quite a process. We've got them approved. All the numbers look good. We're going to hit our 2,000 profit margin and some on this one. So we're going to do really well if the deal goes through tomorrow, but I'm pending, I guess the deal is pending them coming back tomorrow and finishing up everything. So hopefully that goes through tomorrow. Otherwise, this 2006 Mercury Montego, the gray one right there, is pending sale tomorrow as well. I had a guy come by yesterday, drove it. He was looking for something around $3,500. I had it priced at $3,800. Actually ended up getting down to, I think, $3,400 if I'm not mistaken. I have $14 and some change in that one, so this will be a good sell for me. It's been here a little while. I haven't had a ton of interest in it, but it's a good car, reliable. It's leather. It's in great shape, so he's getting a good deal. I'm doing well on it, so that's going to be a good sell tomorrow, assuming it goes through. He called me today just to let me know he was coming by so I can have the paperwork and all done for him tomorrow. So hopefully that's one sale, two sales. I've got a actually walk around the back, I'll show you. We've got a Chevy Equinox that hopefully we have some interest in. Some folks called today, had me fax over a bill of sale to their bank. We had some mix-ups with the actual fax number. We faxed and I kept faxing the wrong person, which they answered the phone and they were getting really frustrated because we could hear them answering but they couldn't hear us. So we finally got the right number, got that sent over. Hopefully we hear from them tomorrow. This is one we were doing some work on today. If you see my tag here, this means that the police had to stop by, tag it. It got picked up. Shout out to MPH, has a YouTube channel. He commented actually that day that I should have it towed. I said, nah, I got this. It didn't work out. It got towed, had to pay $100 to get it, so should have listened to him. Unfortunately, I didn't. But we did get a transmission in this today. So this, and it's locked. This is good to go. Mechanically, everything feels good. If you come in the front here, you'll see that we're missing a bumper cover. Now we have the bumper cover. It's actually in the back. Actually, if you look through, I don't know if you can see through the windshield, probably, maybe not, but it's actually in the back. When we went to pick this up from the auction the day that I purchased it, it was hanging off the front. I was gonna zip tie it, but it was easy. It was just two bolts. We popped it off because it was already hanging. So we threw it in the back so it wouldn't blow off. So we gotta put that on, detail it, do the final checks on everything. We should be good there. This is one here. We're really close. Like, it's on the front line. Someone could come and look at it. It's past inspection. We need a tire for the front, which actually brings me to the back. We just got a tire machine. We mentioned a few episodes ago. We were just starting to use it, actually. Before I mention that, this is a box truck that we're going to be doing some service work on. I had a guy bring it in. I couldn't actually hear him when he called. My phone was breaking up, or either his was. And he said, hey, I got out, and I couldn't hear anything. And I said, okay, well, bring it up. Let me look at it. I can't hear you. Sorry. I thought he had a pickup truck. He has a box truck. So if you look at our shop here, it's not going to fit in here. So we're going to have to do this work outside. He needs brakes and rotors. When you pull these rotors, you have to pull like a bearing type assembly. it's not gonna be the most fun job, and we're gonna hopefully be doing that tomorrow, Thursday, Friday, someday this week. It'd be a good profit job because a lot of folks don't want to work on these, so we're going to do well. It's a guy we've done a lot of work for in the past. It's just the pain and headache of having to actually do it right here outside. So we're going to have to jack it up and do that side by side. But coming in the back here, this is our new equipment that we've just got in. This is a tire that we just got for our Chevrolet Equinox. Now, I mentioned a couple videos ago about why I wanted to purchase this equipment, because I can get tires wholesale through a distributor. Now, you can buy this exact same tire on Amazon, eBay. There's a lot of sites, TireRack.com. You can buy tires directly from, you know, distributors, I guess you could call them, but they're not gonna be the same price that I could pay for them now that I'm set up with a distributor. So for example, this is a, what is it? This is a 225, 65, 17. I paid $51 for this tire. This tire here, which is for the, for the HHR out front, this is a 2, 15, 55, 16. This tire was $30. So it's very difficult to find a tire online. They'll ship it to you and all for $30. That means for me, if I wanted to put a whole set of tires on that, which I'm not, I just needed one, but I could put the whole set for $120. Obviously there's labor and that kind of things. But having this equipment, this being the balance machine here, this being the mounting machine here, tire mounter, this is going to save us and allow us to keep that money that we would spend in-house as opposed to sending it out to other places. So this here, before we get to that, actually, I've been talking about this in the past, sorry, a little scatterbrained today. This is a engine that we have been building to put in our Jeep Wrangler. When I say building, we're not, this isn't souped up or anything, but this comes as just the block assembly with the heads on it. We had to transfer over valve covers. When I say we, as if I'm doing it, unfortunately, I'm not, I didn't do this. Rob, our mechanic, has been putting this together. This is the front timing cover. We've got valve covers up top. We've got to transfer over the oil pan here. So all this has to get transferred over to this. It came blank, so everything gets over to it. We'll then put it in, and then we should be good to go there. I've been doing a little work on the soft top. Hopefully it's coming out good, but I'll take you over here. Some work we've got to do in the front of this before it can sail is behind our rotor here. There's a hub bearing assembly, actually. I won't open it, but I'm gonna see if I can find a picture of it that I could show you, and I cannot. Here we go. Got a knife and everything. We're gonna open this up so I can show you what a hub bearing assembly is. That sounds like something fancy, but it's really not. It's what makes your wheel spin. And if you'll bear with me, we're gonna cut in here and give you a look at it. If you ever have a roar in the front of your vehicle or in the rear of your vehicle, and when you turn side to side, it gets louder or quieter depending on the way you turn, it's very probable that this is your issue. This is a wheel bearing hub assembly, meaning that the bearing is already pressed onto a hub. This is preferable to do from an actual just bearing. If you got to pull this apart, replace the bearing yourself, this is a lot easier because it's already together. You've got three bolts, one, two, three. This is what you're seeing here. So your rotor is mounted to the front here. So we have to pull off the brake caliper, the rotor. This mounts in the back, so these bolts are around back. Once we unbolt these from the back, this falls out. We've got the CV joint nut there, gotta take loose. But once we disassemble all of that, this falls out. We put the new one on, reassemble, you're good to go. This was like $30. It might even been a little bit less on eBay. If you go through Advance or AutoZone, wherever, you're gonna pay $100 for this. I'd prefer not to spend that money. So we go online. I've not had any trouble yet with the quality. Again, I'm just putting it in here to sell it. So I've not had a vehicle 5 years after I've done it, but for me, it increases my profit margin and I've had no complaints as of yet. So I'm gonna put this back up here. Otherwise, the last thing I've been messing with today, and you're gonna see random little pads here. These are actually wet sand pads. This is actually a kit for a lens being your headlight lens. It's a headlight lens renewal system. I hadn't used it in a while. I've had it laying around because I normally just use my buffer and some wet sandpaper. But I had a lot of haze on my windows, and mainly right here, it was very hazy, kind of blistered up. I wet sanded it, two different levels of wet sandpaper using a drill. I don't have the setup, it's somewhere over there, but it's a drill, it's got a little pad on it. This is what you would use if you were buffing. This is a full size one. The one I was using, actually I'll show you because I think it's sitting right over here. This is the actual pad here. So what happens is we take our wet sand piece here. If we were doing headlights, we'd be hitting this to take off. This has a little bit of hay, so we'd want to take that off. We'd go two different grades of this. Then we're going to take our rubbing compound, which is somewhere, and we'd use a buffing pad, which comes with this little mini buffing pad, and then we would clean up the headlights that way. I was experimenting. This isn't really made for this, but I took over two different layers, went over this, and then there is actually a, this is a 3000 grit, very fine wet sand, went over this last, took the rubbing compound, went over it, and as of right now, it looks decent. I mean, it's okay, I haven't seen it out in the sun yet, but as of right now, it's all right. If you come around to the back, this was the worst, and you can start to see it coming back through a little bit. I don't know if the camera's gonna show it very well, but this area in here, this was almost completely white. I mean, you couldn't even hardly see through it. So we've made improvements. Whether or not it's gonna be good enough to sell, I'm letting it sit until I order a new one, and we'll put it outside and see how it handles, you know, the elements. But the top itself is solid. It's in good shape. You'll see this right here bending a little bit. I've had this in the past where they'll be bent all the way like that. If you take a heat gun and some clips and clip it down, this will actually regain its shape and come back in here. So I'll probably do that if it looks like this is gonna hold up. What this would save me is about $300 for this. The problem with this Wrangler in particular, if I were to replace the top, if I have to replace these, the cheapest I've seen this set of upper door surrounds for the Wrangler TJ, this is a, This is a, I forgot what version Wrangler this is. It's horrible because I do a ton of Jeep Wranglers. But this JK, I have no idea why I couldn't remember that. This JK, these door surrounds are about $300 for this set. That's the cheapest that I could find. So I'd have $300 for this. I'd have $300 for this at $600. I'd rather keep that $600 in my profit margin. So I'm gonna hope that these will be sufficient the way that I've cleaned them. So that's why I've tried to do what I've done. So this, as you can see, still has the engine completely removed. Once this is assembled, we'll reassemble everything here. Transmission here, so to hook into the transmission. We've got everything dangling from the side. We'll put this back together. We should be pretty much good to go, assuming the soft top holds up once it gets out in the weather. But that's been my day-to-day. It's been a little busy, but busy is good because busy means profits. Busy means we're making money. So that is definitely a plus. If you have not yet, be sure to check out the podcast, The Car Flip Show. There's a link below to that podcast. There'll be a new episode this coming Friday. I'm really excited about it. We'll be answering some questions. Actually, if you have a question that I could answer on the podcast, I would love your feedback there. You can post it in the comments below. You can send it to me directly via email at justin@thecarflip.com. If you want me to answer it anonymously, I guess it would be your question. I guess I can't answer it anonymously because it's my podcast, but if you don't want your name to be mentioned, post that in the email. I'd be more than happy to answer it that way. Otherwise, if you've not subscribed to this channel, I mean, really, come on, you let me down. Subscribe. I would love to share more helpful information. Hopefully it's been helpful with you in the future. Otherwise, I'll see you guys tomorrow. Have a good afternoon.